Hi, my name is Colleen Nelson, and I'll be reading to you today from my book, Harvey Comes Home, Chapter 1, Harvey. Harvey is a West Highland Terrier, a ratter with a white coat, extra shiny and clean because he was just groomed yesterday. He trots ahead of Maggie, feeling quite smart. He enjoys the chill of the early November air as it rustles against his skin. Tail held high, ears pricked, and nose down low, Harvey follows the scent left by Rosie, another Westie, who has been here recently. He lifts his leg and, with a little squirt, adds his scent to the lamppost. Maggie tugs at the leash, reminding him they are meant to be walking, but all the smells are too distracting. He could spend all day drinking them in at just one lamppost. Not like his yard, where everything is familiar. The only excitement is the squirrels that scamper and race through the treetops, taunting him. He loves and hates those squirrels. He can't imagine his days without them. Like any good ratter, he watches for them. When he sees one invade his yard, he paws at the door and barks to be let out, desperate to chase it. So far on this walk, there have been no squirrels, but the bright smells make up for it. They zip up his nose and into his brain. Harvey can't see bright colors, but if he could, he would know that Maggie has the most beautiful color of hair. Like a hot metal poker, it glows red, orange, and copper, and curls at the ends. Maggie takes her hair for granted, even though it is the first thing people compliment her on. The hair is from her mother, but the slight build and lanky frame are both from her father. She has a smattering of freckles across her nose, and more appear in the summer. Her eyes are small but sharp and quizzical, and teachers think of her as the quiet, studious type. Maggie is at an age when a uniform of tights and a long hoodie is worn daily. Her hair is most often tied up in a ponytail. She doesn't care about clothes or boys, at least not yet. She's happiest at home with Harvey. Harvey never knows what the day will bring with Maggie. Some days she's at home with him, and other days she leaves and comes back with a bag layered with so many smells Harvey could sniff all day and never catch all the scents. Maggie lugs that bag up to her room. She unzips it and sighs, then sits down to work, pencil scratching and papers flipping. Harvey is content to lie in her bed and watch, pleased that his Maggie is home. But today something is different. There's a lot of activity when he and Maggie return from their walk. Harvey lets Maggie unclip his leash. He waits by the door, trying to make sense of the hustle and bustle. He sees Maggie's parents walking with quick, rushed steps and speaking loudly to each other. The two little girls, twins, who often try to grab Harvey's tail, are being jostled about. There are new smells at the front door, and Harvey goes to inspect them. Besides the usual scents of leather, wool, and outdoor grit, Harvey sniffs out three big things. They're lined up in a row and smell of the damp basement. He catches a whiff of the stuffed bunny from Maggie's room, the one he's not supposed to grab, locked inside one of the cases. What is it doing in there, he wonders. He paws at the case and sniffs intently, looking for other trap scents. He's concentrating so hard that he doesn't know Maggie is behind him until she reaches out and grabs him. She holds him close to her chest and whispers in his ear, "I love you so much, Harves. I'm going to miss you." Harvey hears the catch in her voice. He pokes his black nose into her face and sees that her eyes sparkle with tears. Harvey licks at her chin, desperate to make sense of all this. A car pulls up outside. He barks to let everyone know, but gets an annoyed shh from Maggie's father before he's even finished. Harvey takes a few steps forward. Natural curiosity makes his tail point straight in the air as he waits for the door to open. When it does, a girl, taller than his Maggie, steps in. Voices rise with excitement and greeting. Joining the fray, Harvey runs up to welcome the girl, but is gently scolded to stay back. The new girl holds out her hand for him and crouches down. She's wearing jeans with holes in the knees so he can smell flowery lotion. He sniffs out her heavy leather boots, the kind of boots he'd love to gnaw on, but knows he can't. Leather boots are his favorite. They hold scents, and the flavor explodes in his mouth, not to mention the sensation on his tongue, like a good belly rub. "Hey, Harvey," she says. He likes her voice. It's soft and encouraging. He noses closer, curious. "Harvey, this is Olivia. She's going to look after you." Maggie uses the same sing-song voice he's heard her use with the little girls. His Maggie wants him to like this girl. He'll do anything for his Maggie. So he takes a polite sniff of her hand, likes the smells, and gives it an appreciative lick. The girl's hand darts up to his head and rubs between his ears. Then she stands up. Harvey isn't ready for the head scratch to be over. He steps closer to her and stands on his hind legs, reaching his front paws up her legs. His nails pull on the denim. "Harvey," Maggie's mother admonishes. He's about to get down, but the girl shakes her head and says, "It's okay." And Harvey is rewarded with another head scratch. He likes this girl. There's no jumping or fidgeting like some of Maggie's other friends. Confident that she poses no threat, Harvey goes to Maggie, who sinks to the floor and gives him a cuddle. His Maggie. His eyes half close with contentment. Maggie's mother leads the girl into the house and chatters to her. He's so comfortable on the tile floor beside Maggie that he almost misses the sound of another car in the driveway. Taxi's here, Maggie calls out, but her voice is choked. Harvey turns to face her, tilting his head. There's a rush to the door. Maggie's father appears from his office, and everyone collects together, waiting. Harvey's skin prickles, just like it does when Maggie is sick. Something is going on, something different. Maggie holds him tightly against her chest. He can feel her heart beating and hear her sniffle. We're going on a trip, Harvey. Me, Mom, Dad, and the twins. You're staying here with Olivia. He senses trepidation in her voice and pricks his ears. She rubs his back thoughtfully as her father drags the suitcases outside. Another man helps him, and Harvey yelps, catching a quick whiff of new smells. And then there's more action. Maggie stands up, jackets are handed out, twins are wrangled. Maggie's father comes back inside and shouts instructions. Harvey stands on his hind legs and stretches up to Maggie's knees. He needs her attention. Bye, Harvey, she says. She zips her jacket and takes hold of the suitcase that has her favorite things trapped inside. Little wheels on the bottom make it roll across the floor. Here, Harvey, Olivia calls. He can smell a treat in the air. He isn't sure what he's done to earn it, but he turns to the smell and sniffs it out. It crunches in his mouth. When he turns back, the door is shut and his Maggie has disappeared. Where is she? He races to the window in the front room and looks out over the driveway. He watches as the taxi departs, stuffed full with his Maggie and her family. He can see her staring back at him. She raises her hand to wave, and then his Maggie is gone. Good night, Greenwich.